Monday, May the 16th, 2022. I think around 4 o'clock, mid-80s. We're still in Alabama. Tractor Supply looks like they're having a tent sale out there. I guess bushes and stuff keep the sun off of them. Left on Alabama 68, or either County Road 68, Cherokee County. I need to get over. There's about 5 cars coming up. Showing Alabama 68 east. 411 is straight. That would take us right into Rome. My assistant says this is the best way. Cedar Bluff 5, 18 miles, we're going to turn left on 100, I think it'll be in Georgia, because I don't think it would be 100 in Alabama. Well, it is, because it's got an oblong, it's not showing a Georgia. Well, we'll find out when we get there. Gadsden State Community College. far today, the drives have been very pleasant. A lot of egrets over there, the great white egrets or the big egrets. Guessing Lake Weiss. Cedar Bluff Town Limit. I'll turn it off and start another one for Center Bluff. Monday, the 16th of May, 2022. About 4:15 in the afternoon, and that's still Alabama. We're gonna lose an hour, that'll be 5:15. I guess, I'm looking at the phone. I don't know what the phone's got, Central or Eastern time. There's a Piggly Wiggly. Dollar General. Alabama 9 North. about three of the people that were behind us turned. Now we just got three more. And if they want to come around, they need to do it. I can't pull over for everybody and let them by. They either have to sit back there and enjoy the ride or put the foot on the gas and come around. Miles will turn left on 100. I'm pretty sure she's going to take us in the back way down Big Texas Valley, and it's very curvy and narrow on this end. I'm just going to have to be careful. Big trucks come through there and campers come through there. Big trucks aren't supposed to come through there, but they do. Cornwall furnace. We've got video of the Cornwall furnace. It's a nice pig iron furnace. And if anybody wants to see the pine log furnaces, it might be advisable to get on your horse and get up there and see them, because that property has been put up for sale. About 14,000 acres, wildlife management area, but it is privately owned. And they're trying to sell it for a logistics warehouse area. And that whole area there at White is full of that stuff already. I don't know. That's very doubtful they would try to preserve those historic furnaces. But they might. Mixed feelings. I'd really like for the state of Georgia to step up and buy it, but you know, it'd be our tax dollars that to be spending. It's got a lot of history through that site. Beautiful land, some really hilly stuff, clear water, clear spring, springs and creeks, trout streams. They stock them every couple of weeks. Really gorgeous piece of property. Saw a lot up here at Dawsonville when the city of Atlanta bought that piece of property for a second airport up north. They never have built it, but they still own that property. And that's a Georgia Wildlife Management area too. One of these days, I suspect the city of Atlanta is going to sell it. Clear cut everything. Flatten it out. Gainesville, Alabama, to the left. We are not far across the Georgia-Alabama line. I recognize this place. This is going to turn into Georgia 20. We just came by a Civil War battlefield site where the Confederate general tricked the Union forces into surrendering, making them think that he had about a 3 times larger superior force than he did. And the Union commander actually had the gall to complain about it, saying he was tricked. Cross the line up here, Georgia 20, it'd take us right through Rome. It'd also take us through Cartersville, Canton, on down past through the Roswell, Alpharetta, all down through there. End up all the way on the south side through Conyers. 272, and like I said, this is, no, it's not, this isn't 411 anymore. I don't know if this is from the state line or not. I'm assuming it is. That could be wrong. I give out a lot of wrong information. Y'all hadn't figured it out yet. If you watch much of my stuff, you'll know. State Line Tavern. We've got one big truck behind us. It wouldn't surprise me if he's going to go Georgia 100 like us. There is need for a cut through from US 27 over to Georgia 100 over to this side to bypass Rome. Be interesting to see what they're going to do in the next 10 years. Trying to get from 75, 140 dead ends into 27, and they need a way to get on across over here to Alabama without having to go through Rome. Feeling somebody's going to lose some property. We have seen very little cattle on this road trip. This spring has been, I think, unusually windy. We're still getting a lot of wind. Over a mile ahead. I'll be turning it off at 100 because I've got 100 to Somerville, I think. And I know I've got Big Texas Valley all the way over to 27. Truck's not pushing us at all. That's unusual. He's back a couple of hundred yards. Okay, we'll be turning left right up here at 100 and turning it off. Straight.